Hey, my name is Sujay Pillai. I work as a senior DevOps engineer for Jebel in Penang, Malaysia.
Okay.
And I'm also a Docker captain and community leader for Docker Penang Meetup Group.
Cool. You actually do community in Penang.
Yes.
What do you actually do in a high level way?
So right now, being in a DevOps environment, I'm responsible for setting up the Docker environment within my organization. I teach people with the Docker tools and technologies around it. Build up a CI/CD system which helps to deploy a faster application in our environment rather than going and doing it manually.
Okay, so from what I hear from you, your tools of choice is Docker.
Yes.
Is there anything else you use on top of that?
So, if you give me any language, I would help you to containerize it using Docker technology.
Okay.
So, any tool you come with, any language specific you come with, we help the customers to convert it into a Docker container.
Cool.
So, that's not specific to any language.
Nice. Okay, so the question is then why? Assume I don't know.
Okay. So the reason is in the normal world, if you had to package those applications into different environment, you would have to manually do everything in a different setup in a different environment. Say that I had to move that from dev stage prod. Three pieces of individual work has to be done to set up that environment and make that flow happen. So when you move those things into a Docker container, you push it to a central place which is called Docker registry, and all you need to have is that Docker installed on all of the environment. That app is Dockerized and it's there for you to run without any change.
Cool. So do you happen to use Docker Swarm and all that?
Yes, we do heavily use Docker Swarm.
Alright.
But we are also looking into Kubernetes also, which is a good choice right now in the industry.
Alright.
But more of Docker Swarm is what we do.
Okay. Can you make a comparison between the two?
Like, I'm a good supporter of Docker Swarm, so I would say very easy to start up with, rather than comparing with Kubernetes, which is like 5-6 different description files to start up with, and the various commands and tools around it, which makes kind of a little bit hard to start with, but it's more mature than Docker Swarm, I would say. So that's the reason Docker company itself is bringing the tool into their product suite. So right now in the Docker, they have the choice of orchestration between Kubernetes and Docker Swarm.
Okay, cool. So let's, in the earlier you say you actually move around Docker community in Penang.
Yes.
How big is it?
So we started this last December and we had organized around 4-5 meetups, and we have on the meetup page, if you see, we have 70 members.
Okay.
But normally when we conduct the meetup, it's around 15 to 20 attendance.
Okay.
So what we do is that we encourage all the peoples to come down and learn what Docker is, and invite some speakers who are interested to give a talk, and that's how we share our knowledge.
So do you have a demography of who's the user down in Penang, in the user group?
So mostly
corporate or whatnot? Can
it's mostly it's a corporate thing. Very rarely I see students from the universities, but it's mostly corporate.
Alright, interesting. So where can we find Docker Penang?
So there is two places. If you go to meetup.com, there is a Penang meetup chapter. But Docker itself is providing a tool which is called events.docker.com, and you can sign up there using your Docker account, and there is a Penang chapter.
Okay.
So we are more prioritizing things on the Docker website.
Alright.
So that's how the communication channel goes.
Okay. Cool.
This is the first time I'm attending Python conference. But I do actively join the Penang Python meetup group, and this was a good experience for me because I gave a talk how to run Django app in Docker containers.
Nice. So thanks for the interview. So I hope you have a good experience.
Yep. Thank you.
All right.
Thanks. All right. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem.